And Speaker, it is with humility and strong passion and a sense of the enormity of the events that have occasioned this honorable, the honorable member, sorry, Madam Speaker, it was my attention that I have not yet read the resolution, so I think I probably ought to do that.
Yes.
But reading it to the record. Whereas, by proclamation made under Section 17(2) of the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Dominica on the 18th day of September 2017, the President declared that a state of public emergency exists in Dominica. And whereas, by virtue of Section 17(4) of the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Dominica, a proclamation made under Section 17(2) shall, unless previously revoked, remain in force for 21 days or for such longer period, not exceeding 6 months, as the House of Assembly may determine by a resolution supported by the votes of a majority of all members of the House. And whereas it is desirable that the proclamation declaring a period of a state of public emergency remain in force in Dominica, be it resolved that in accordance with Section 17(4) of the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Dominica, this Honorable House determines that the proclamation declaring a state of public emergency in Dominica made by the President on the 18th of September 2017 shall remain in force until the 31st day of December 2017. Madam Speaker, the original order, resolution as circulated provided for a longer period, which was just for the record and for information, the 17th of March 2018. And that has now been amended to the 31st of December, that is to say to take it to the end of this year. And if it is to be necessary, then of course we can come back to the House and the House can debate a further resolution of the matter. That seems, Madam Speaker, to be a more appropriate course at this time. So, Madam Speaker, as I was saying, it is with humility and strong passion and a sense of the enormity of the events that have occasioned honourable members to be summoned here today that I present this resolution to this honourable House for debate and, I trust, approval. Mr. Clerk. Madam Speaker, the resolution seeks the extension of the current state of emergency put in place pursuant to a proclamation made by His Excellency the President in accordance with the provisions of Section 17 of the Constitution of Dominica on the 18th of September 2017. That proclamation automatically expires by operation of law after 21 days, Madam Speaker, unless sooner extended by a resolution supported by a majority of all members of House. As all members of this Honourable House and those hearing these words will doubtless concur, we are at a dark time in this nation's history and development. We are in exceptionally extraordinary times indeed, Madam Speaker. This darkness, this extraordinariness, has been imposed upon this beautiful country and its population by an uninvited and unwanted visit of an extraordinary natural phenomenon. Madam Speaker, on the night of the 18th day of September, into the early morning hours of the 19th of September of 2017, Hurricane Maria, which I am told is the most powerful hurricane recorded, and which the experts have attributed Category 5 status to, though many assert that was in reality a Category 5++, having made its way across the Atlantic Ocean, building up its enormously destructive power and malevolence, struck this country direct blow, unleashing a sheer brutality, ferocity, and heartless cruelty on us. Hurricane Maria inflicted unspeakable terror, wanton destruction, and devastation on our nation. Perhaps for the first time in our history, certainly so far as I have been able to ascertain, for the first time in living memory, a hurricane has absolutely devastated this beautiful rich isle, from Capuchin in the north to Scotshead in the south. from Coolabah Street on the western coast to Castle Bruce on the eastern coast. Never before, Madam Speaker, has any of us in this honourable house, or indeed probably listening to my voice, seen such extensive devastation. In a few terrifying hours, Dominica and its development were set back decades by the onslaught of a triple whammy: ferocious winds, surging seas, and raging rivers. Years and years of toil, sweat, blood, and labor callously swept aside. Death and destruction are the hallmarks of the passage of this savage hurricane named Maria. I am advised that the confirmed death toll currently stands at 26, with 32 people missing. Madam Speaker, I pause here to extend my deepest personal condolences to the family and friends of all those who perished in this terrible hurricane. Also, Madam Speaker, I extend my own and the government's sympathy, understanding, and support to those who have suffered physical injury and to those who have sustained terrible damage and loss of property. I also take this opportunity to confirm the government's determination and commitment to continue to get to the peace.
Madam
Speaker, may I suggest that I read the resolution after what I say and I second it, because that really is the substance of what goes on. I'm grateful, Madam Speaker. I also take this opportunity to confirm the government's determination and commitment to continue to get to the people the food, the water, and other necessary immediate support required by them. It is not an easy task by any means. In fact, it is a humongous task, but it is a task, as he will no doubt touch upon, that the Honourable Prime Minister is leading this government in fulfilling. Systems are being improved daily. More roads are being cleared or made passable. More areas are being reconnected to pipeline water. Electricity is increasingly being restored. Telecommunications are becoming more readily accessible, among other advances. Madam Speaker, members of this Honourable House, it is essential that the state of emergency remains in effect to enable these advances in the restoration of essential services and the recovery of this country from the ravages of Hurricane Maria to continue with even greater speed, efficiency, and effectiveness. Madam Speaker, turning now from the effects of nature inflicted upon this nation by Mother Nature, which we have no option but to accept, to the utterly unnecessary, unacceptable, despicable, and more sinister human devastation inflicted upon the nation by a greedy, selfish, self-indulgent minority of criminals and misguided members of our society who engaged in vandalism, looting, and, yes, plain burglary and theft. They have brought shame to themselves, their families, and to the nation. They have not assisted, and in some instances have hampered, the relief and recovery efforts of this nation. This kind of behavior will not be permitted or tolerated in a civilized society such as ours. The Office of the Attorney General will, in due course, be pursuing these matters with the police and prosecuting authorities to seek out and prosecute all those, including those who may be in high places, who engage in this wanton looting and lawlessness. We cannot build a viable country on lawlessness and anarchy, and those who seek to perpetuate that kind of behavior in our society will be dealt with firmly and preferably swiftly. Never again must this kind of behavior be allowed to occur in this country. Those who are genuinely remorseful for their actions have the opportunity and would be well advised to avail themselves of, to demonstrate their remorse, to begin to make amends, and perhaps to save themselves more severe consequences by voluntarily going to a police station or police officer and handing back the goods looted, burgled, and stolen. Madam Speaker, may I also take this opportunity to remind and inform the population that, like a state of emergency, a curfew. I am advised that the number of arrests in respect to curfew violations currently stands at 92. The curfew order is in place consistent with the Constitution and an Act of Parliament, and the citizenry must comply with that order. Those who fail to do so are exposing themselves to possible very serious consequences. Both the curfew order and the state of emergency have been put in place as they are essential for securing the well-being of society and the citizenry as a whole. Madam Speaker, I strongly urge all of the citizenry to comply with these essential measures, which will be revoked as soon as it is prudent to do so. Finally, Madam Speaker, members of this Honourable House, it needs to be emphasised that the sole reason for seeking to continue the state of emergency is to enable the country to be run, to ensure the security that's necessary, to enable us to get to a point where all the necessary essential works are done. We know we need the roads to be cleaned, so we need an expedited cleanup. We need other recovery actions, all necessary for the country to return to normalcy, or as near as normalcy, in the shortest possible time. That cannot be achieved, Madam Speaker, in current time, without there being, in effect, the support of the state of emergency. In those circumstances, Madam Speaker, I respectfully submit to this Honourable House that there is no good reason for any member of this House not to support this resolution. And I would be extremely disappointed if any member did not give this resolution their full support. Madam Speaker, finally, to say that the state of emergency will have no adverse bearing on business operations. The country is open for business, but of course, the more we can get back to normalcy, the quicker we can get back to engaging in full-blown business. Madam Speaker, I commend this resolution to the House and invite the support of all members of this Honourable House to support the resolution, provided for the state of emergency to remain in effect for the remainder of the year, namely until 31st of December 2017. I thank you, Madam Speaker, members of the Honourable House. Thank you. Madam Speaker, I think you I'm required to read the resolution back into the record. So if I may, Madam Speaker, whereas by proclamation made under section 17.2 of the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Jamaica on the 18th day of September 2017, the President declared that a state of public emergency exists in Jamaica. And whereas by virtue of section 17.4 of the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Jamaica, a proclamation made under section 17.2 shall, unless previously revoked, remain in force for 21 days, or for such longer period, not exceeding 6 months, as the House of Assembly may determine by a resolution supported by the votes of a majority of all members of the House. And whereas it is desirable that the proclamation declaring a period of state of public emergency remain in force in Dominica, be it resolved that in accordance with section 17.4 of the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Dominica, this Honourable House determines that the proclamation declaring a state of public emergency in Dominica made by the President on the 18th day of September 2017 shall remain in force until the 31st of December 2017.
Second.